The Commerce Commission is asking questions of Carter Holt Harvey over its decision to stop supplying timber to some major stores due to shortages. Building industry representatives met today to discuss the problem, and they're warning the situation could get worse. Katie Bradford reports.
Sparse shelves at some of our biggest hardware stores, a headache for our building industry.
It's a perfect storm, unfortunately.
A storm caused by Carter Holt Harvey's decision to stop supplying timber to some stores, and it's putting building developments, big and small, at risk.
We're talking about a 5 to 10% sort of shortage.
It could affect issues around our pipeline of supply and our construction plans.
A building boom, COVID, shipping delays, and the popularity of renovations all being blamed. Some builders have been stockpiling timber and other materials. Carter Holt Harvey has ignored requests for comment, but its decision to close its Whangarei mill last year is being blamed for making the problem worse.
I've had some delays and struggles getting the Kawerau mill up and running, and that's all compounding.
And other sawmills are at capacity.
They're all producing as much as they can. It's the demand from housing is so extreme at the moment that they just can't meet it.
The problem is that you can't step this up overnight. If you've gone down to a certain level of production, it's very hard to then ramp it back up at the drop of a hat.
Rotorua's Red Stag Mill says it will do what it can, hiring staff and ramping up production,
as well as bring back a little bit from non-committed exports.
While we export a lot of wood, we do have enough raw logs. It's the processing of them that's the issue. And we can't increase imports because markets around the world are having the same problem. And the bad news doesn't end there.
The price of timber has gone up already, and it will go up again because it's in short supply.
Red Stag is about to open a plant producing cross-laminated timber, a very fast, very strong product for use in large-scale building products.
So strategically, from the government's perspective, what they could look at doing is really focusing Maimora's demand and designs on cross-laminated timber to free up framing timber for the rest of the industry to use.
The shortages may last up to 6 months, and if solutions aren't found, could lead to a very sudden stop to our building boom.
Katie, there's a lot of interest in the wider impact of this on housing. Is it going to fuel the current crisis?
Well, all eyes are really on this. The Commerce Commission says it's going to be asking those questions of Carter Holt Harvey because it was aware of the wider building supply issue, but it was not aware of this timber issue. It wants to know why. The government also, of course, very worried about it. It does not want anything holding up those plans to build as many houses as possible. Now, Building Minister Portal Williams has been on the phone today to the building industry to find out what's going on, to look at possible solutions. But look, there is a construction accord in place that was signed by government and industry representatives that was meant to keep ahead of issues like this, to look at mitigating them, to make sure that everyone was on the same page about the pipeline of work that was coming, about any issues that may arise. Clearly this has taken people by surprise and really shouldn't have, given that accord was in place. And from the government's point of view, they will not want this to be continuing. They want the work on house building to be speeding up, not slowing down.
Ngā mihi e hoa in Auckland, Katie Bradford.